right, so Meta Black are going to be playing the composition Zico is talking about with the Outlaw Elemental, whereas Super Rejects are going to be playing Elemental Destruction. And I actually kind of give this matchup to the Super Rejects. We're going to see if Meta Black can make the switches to Envious. We saw Meta Black in previous tournaments switch to Zuniaki when he played Holy Priest, completely blow him out of the game. So Envious needs to be ready for those swaps, Joe.
Indeed, and Wes is going to be on that Outlaw Rogue, so he's going to be the player to watch. They're going to set up a lot of kills with that Plunder Armor and the most amount of stuns ever. He gets stunned though himself. Chaos Boss come flying in from Thugonomics. He's gonna be high HP, but he lands a cap stun on the chest. He could just be taken out straight away, maybe get a cooldown here, but it looks like they'll be okay. Chaz gonna use that Archangel, and this might be a very damp game too.
Yeah, I can imagine the Super Rejects, they're gonna focus on dragging Thugonomics into bad, focus on dragging Waz into bad positions, stun lock him and burst him down. So Waz needs to be ready for those switches as Envious will look to capitalize on bad positioning. In the meantime though, Chaz and Swaps here just staying far away from the fight, tag teaming, hexing up Smex, and Thugonomics going for a Chaos Ball. There's that deadly Chastise stun. Waz bursts it down to half HP, but Chaz deflects with that perfectly placed barrier.
Indeed, and if things are gonna go to mana, Envious will probably win that low. The Chaos Ball's coming out onto Waz. Once again, they need to be very careful. Swapsy and Chaz just staying max range right now. They're going to avoid it all game. Thugonomics is just going to be looking for those openings onto Wes time and time again. He's still a bit low there. Smekton looking for a Hex. Lands onto Swapsy. Counter spell onto Chaz as well. Pressuring Chaz, getting rid of that Vim and Vigor. Wes is dropping low. He needs to use that Cloak of Shadows. And there's the first cooldown defensively of the game.
Ooh, they just got Trinket from Envious with that blind. They can now switch to him later on. Plunder Armor is available. Waz is going to keep his eyes open for that. Envious needs to be careful. Swapsy just playing back with Chaz. It does appear to be that Meta Black are looking for dampening as Waz is really the only offensive player on their team. Swapsy now trying to make a push across, at least into somewhat center field. We see double Mortal Coils. Chaos Bolts off the back of the Chastise stun. Envious tag teaming with Smites. Potentially a lot of damage towards Waz. Not enough though. Chaz was ready and waiting with that Rapture already rolling, able to pick Waz up quite effectively.
Indeed, and one thing to note is Smexen and Thugonomics, they're on those Orc racials, so that's going to be very annoying for Wes to set up kill potential a lot easier. But Smexen's dropping really low here. He might have to use the Astral Shift. The Ray of Hope gets used by Envious, and hopefully that should be enough to top him up, and I would imagine before dampening is. He didn't actually get topped too much. Swapsy just pounding into him with those lava bursts, doing an incredible amount of damage. Wes making a swap over to Thugonomics as well, trying to make it harder for Envious to heal this, but it looks like they're able to stabilize.
Yeah, and this is kind of a difficult decision. If Swapsy goes in the center of map, he's going to take a ton of damage, so they opt to only use Waz in center field, but that Chastise stun could take Waz down. Nice life grip, but Chaz is getting pressured. I like what Smexton is doing. He's splitting his pressure on two targets, removing the Vim, as you said, Joe, removing 20% increased healing from the Priest, and then also focusing down Waz. And the Super Rejects are looking to try and keep that split pressure, soften up both targets, and then push in with the Chastise stun to burst somebody down in the center of the map. Smexton just chasing down Chaz. Fear, Thugonomics looking to resummon that Fell Hunter. Doesn't want to get caught without that pet for far too long. Thugonomics trinkets out. Full Hex secured on Envious. Stunned on to Smexton for cross crowd control. Smexton trinkets out. Was almost stunned on his trinket. Waz almost closing the game there. Now Chaos Bolts are flying as Chaz ducks behind the corner.
Yeah, trinkets being used by both teams there defensively. They want to avoid this pressure from the Chaos Bots and also from that Outlaw Rogue damage. He still has that Plunder Armor bit holding on it, trying to wait to get more defensive cooldowns and then have that clean setup and just be able to take them down.
All right, Earthshock stun on Waz with a spell lock on Chaz. Decent crowd control setup, but not enough damage to really accomplish too much. Full Fear onto Waz. Thugonomics looks to cast off those spears so he can't be interrupted. There's the Chastise. Envious tag teaming down. Will this Chaos Bolt connect? Two Chaos Bolts towards Waz. Pain suppression from Chaz to deny the follow-up damage from Smexen. That will allow Waz to stay aggressive and on target. But it does seem to be that dampening will be the name of the game here. And early on, it seems to be a huge advantage to Super Rejects as they've got three members below 80% currently.
Indeed, they just need to keep looking out for those swaps. And if they're going to be able to survive those, they can out-damp them. Chaz, you know, around half a match mana, and Smexen just came in low. Raz game very low now. Had to use the human racial Cloak of Shadows to survive it. Those are huge cooldowns against Super Rejects, and now there could be an opportunity to take him down.
Yeah, definitely. We see Waz just grappling, hooking back to the pillar next to Swapsy, looking to avoid the wizard cleave from Super Rejects. For the first time in the day, we've seen double caster in the tournament, and if you overextend, you will be punished. So you're usually hiding behind the pillar and then making hit and run moves, jumping out, stunning somebody, going for burst. first and then retreating away. Right now we see them pushing with tons of damage on to Smexen, caught into the stun. Waz crowd controlling the whole team, trying to maybe snap the trinket, not able to find it though. Cheap shot on the trinket, tons of damage, dipping dangerously low, full gouge, astral shift on 10%. Waz gets speared away. Thugonomics with clutch peels, but a hex with the stun for cross crowd control. Great teamwork between Swapsy and Waz, but just a little bit too much healing there for Smexen. He was able to stay alive. Really good teamwork from both sides.
Indeed, that was crazy. Envious held up to that Ray of Hope and the Guardian Spirit there, knowing that astral shift would be enough even when he's that low. That was a great hold from Super Rejects, and players like that are going to help them get into Dampening. But at the same time, Chad's rank completely full on mana, so that's going to give them a lot of help going into Dampening right now.
Yeah, they could have a huge single target burst deep into Dampening with that Disciplined Priest onto anybody, really. Smexen dipped to 10% in that last attack. We get to 20% or even 40% Dampening. He doesn't survive that attack, so I think the Super Rejects need to be careful to not let that cross crowd control kind of get out of control. We see a stun on Swapsy currently as Smexen's Stormkeeper is trying to rain down fire onto Chaz behind the pillar, but not able to fully connect. Now Swapsy looking to try and set up one of his own. We see a gouge. Waz setting up for some damage potentially, but Waz gets Earthshock stunned away. Not able to really follow up with too much just yet. Now switching over to Smexen, but now Thugonomics is open. He's lobbing out Chaos Bolts. One for Swapsy, ducks behind the corner. He's going to pick himself back up. Smexen now under fire. Just so much pressure on Smexen right now. Stun onto Envious. Smexen 17 seconds away from that Astral Shift. Envious has a lot of defensives. He needs to be careful and rotate through them. Ray of Hope denies damage, but he needs to heal into it to allow it to atop him back to full. How big is this going to be? Not very big at all. Just at the last second, Serenity going to be a huge heal topping Smexen off. But now with no Trinket on Envious, he's still an open target. We're just setting into Dampening.
Indeed, and getting later into this Dampening, the Ray of Hope Serenity might not be enough to top it off, so Super Rejects have to be careful of that. They need to try and get more pressure, force that Cloak of Shadows from Waz, and look to try and kill him. I like Thugonomics' position right in the middle of the map, just spamming out those Chaos Bolts and Fears, just disrupting their gameplay and getting kills as well. The Gouge over the Envious, it looks like they're trying to go onto Thugonomics, maybe force his Demonic Resolve right now. He's pretty low on HP, he gets kicked from Waz, he's going to spam out the Fears. This is what I was talking about, he's going to look to get a Chaos Ball. He actually lands one on the Swapsy, does a chunk of HP, but the peels from Waz are going to be fine. He's dropping Smexen now as well. He has the Astral Shift needed. Full blind on the Envious. He trinkets out, uses that Serenity, but now he doesn't have the Ray of Hope for a while. He might get the Astral Shift. No, a beautiful big kill coming out from Envious.
Yeah, Swapsy, what's he going to do? He's been playing defensive tag team with Chaz this entire game, but Waz is now exposed. The Chaos Ball being casted. Trinket kick from Waz will allow him to survive that attack, but Soul Harvest available, Stormkeeper available. Thugonomics and Smexen can both do a devastating amount of damage right now in the next coming seconds, and Waz is likely to be the target with no Trinket. He's trying to retreat back to the pillar, but he may have been caught. Nice dispel from Chaz allows Waz to duck behind the pillar just in the nick of time.
Indeed, he does get one Chaos Ball, but he's just able to line of sight the second one. If he tanks one at high HP, he'll usually be fine, but when it gets deeper into Dampening, Chaz is once again behind on mana, so he needs to be able to keep them
up. Waz!
Full Hex on the Thugonomics as well. Waz gets stunned. That Hex just pretty much stops them from getting any momentum. Chaos Balls are coming out, but he gets mind controlled. Bit of an overlap there. The Pain Suppression did come out there from Chaz as well on the Waz. Another Chaos Ball chunks his HP into another one as well. They really need to stop these.
Yeah, but he's opting to go after Smexen. He's a bit less tanky, and he can't use defense as well. But they make a swap to Envious with no trinket. They're going all in for the kill. Tons of damage. Guardian Angel denies it, but they burst right through it. They do the miracle swap, catching Envious in the center field and immediately punishing. They're still playing it out. Waz is trying to deny the kill, gouging up Thugonomics, his unending resolve, Chaos Bolts. They're playing it out. Obviously, as a Holy Priest, when you die, you turn into an angel like this. You can heal for a couple of seconds, and then you go away, such as this. So they tried to play it out with that couple of seconds with angel time, but not enough. And Method Black set up the perfect swap.
I mean, so many things went right there. I mean, first of all, Chaz was pretty much out of mana at a certain point, and you could see there, he didn't really even have that much left. Maybe a quarter of a tank. That drink going to be massive, but also their ability to get that swap into play, and that is something that we have seen from them countless times, Z.
It's just such a beautiful thing to watch when they set up these big, big goes on the healer, no trinket, and then they get that stun, and they cloak offensive to avoid the death coil and the fears and all that disruption on the side of the Super Rejects, and they get that stun into that stun, into that elemental shaman stun, and they take down Envious through the Guardian Spirit, 30% healing. I mean, that's a whole bunch of HP, but they have the damage to follow it up. And Method, when you're applying so much pressure onto Smexen, Envious is going to believe that, hey, I have to use my cooldowns onto Smexen. And this is just another one of these beautiful setups from Method Black, you can see here, Waz is controlling up both Smexin as well as Envious with those stun locks here. And you can see Waz is in between them. You don't want to be this far up if you are Envious. He needs to be a little bit further back. Chaz as well is standing here in a nice safe position, casting out those mind controls. And of course, Swapsy is going to have a field day over here with that big, big lava burst flying in. And this is really the kind of moments that make Envious doubt himself, honestly, because they get a cheap shot into that gouge. Smexin has to use his defensive cooldowns. Chaz is doing a lot of damage, tanking that spell lock. Swapsy follows it up with a hex. And in these moments make Smexin, he just becomes the main top.
All right, gates about to open. Method Black going to be leading by one. Will they be able to get on match point here?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, EU has just been dominating and North America all day. Will the Super Rejects be able to turn it around? They've locked in Tolvaron Arena, a very large map, as you would expect for a caster cleave to try and drag people into bad positions. But I can imagine that Method Black are going to be doing that hit and run. They're currently running behind the pillar, looking for a target that overextends. Smexin right now taking the brunt of this exchange. Waz moving forward for some crowd control onto Envious. Holy Ward will be removed and now gouged away. Now Waz immediately switching back to Smexin, but getting feared off. Good peels from Thugonomics on this first attack from Waz.
Indeed, and Thugonomics made their offensive gateway right there from the middle of the map to their pillar, and it looks like Method Black are just going to kite away from those gateways. And, you know, I think that comes from Swapsy's defensive play there, knowing where to position with Chaz, just constantly lining the Chaos Balls and stopping them. They only really have a kill opportunity to Waz. Chaos Balls come flying. Waz is 100% HP. The shield's coming out from Chaz. The Rapture Archangel as well to keep him topped for now.
Yep, but on this map, Chaz will have to sneak for drinks, and it looks like Method Black are just on the back foot right now. They can't get an offensive footing, otherwise they'll just get blown away by Thugonomics. He's dropped the gateway. He's getting ready potentially for a push. He could just gate on top of them if they position badly here. Envious caught into a stun. Good cross crowd control on Smexin as well. He's trying to duck behind the corner, but gets stunned up. Now a blind from Waz. He tries to sap the trinket again, but Envious faded the sap. He trinket fade to immune the sap. There's a nice read by Envious.
Indeed, and they get a lot of pressure from Smexin. They're just punishing his aggression when he pushes it, but now that Envious doesn't have that trinket, they could make
a move,
but Smexin's getting pretty low. He drops so incredibly low. They overlap the Astral Shift and Rarefy. I don't really blame them for that, but that is an overlap of defensives. And now Envious still doesn't have that trinket and no Astral Shift for quite some time. This is looking devastating for Super Rejects.
Yeah, Waz and Swapsy and Chaz are basically just poking. They just poke at them, and then as soon as they can get something from them, they immediately run away, and then they try to poke them again. And it's difficult as a Destruction Warlock to deal with a poke strategy because you want someone committed to it a long distance for quite a long time. We see Waz overextending on Envious, looking for a gouge. Smexin Lights of Wrath going to be connecting onto him. Tons of Lava Burst as well. Envious trying to pick him up. He's got that Guardian Spirit, though, to fall back on if he absolutely needs to. He would like to keep it for himself, having no trinket. Waz goes for a stun, makes the swap to Thugonomics, looking to pull more defensive cooldowns from the team of Super Rejects. Envious now out of that stun and starting to restabilize. Chaos Bolts, one, two Chaos Bolts potentially. No, gets wind sheared and denied there by Swapsy. Now into a stun, good denial from Method Black.
Indeed, I love that Swapsy is just waiting in for keep casting that Chaos Bolt, and then just interrupts it very late. What, Chaz getting put into a spell, though, and drop really low there. Smexin and Swapsy are doing a ton of pressure individually from these guys. They're just doing an excellent job on these Elemental Shamans. A kick onto Smexin as well, going to deny as much pressure as possible. Waz even looking to line of sight Thugonomics. Chaos Bolt 1 looking like it's coming in onto Swapsy, actually. Swapsy a bit out of position there, just gets back. He's going to be fine for now.
Yeah, we see Waz just in the center field. He's spending a lot of time poking right now, and it might be too much. He needs to be careful. It's a difficult thing to juggle, but he's taking a lot of damage now. Caught into the chest. Chaz is going to life trip him back to safety, but Swapsy gets swapped to by Smexin. Rain of Fire down on the whole team. They're immediately retreating out of that Rain of Fire. Chaz's mana is not looking that hot, and although Method Black got a lot of defensive cooldowns earlier, Super Rejects have stalled it out now so that they're very stable, and this is looking more and more so in favor of Super Rejects.
Indeed, they've been getting a lot more pressure, and it could be that Tolvaron map coming to effect here. Just the wide space of area allowing them to free cast more and more. The double quirk coming out from Thermonoids. It instantly gets dispelled by Chaz before his one lands on him. That was excellent play by Chaz there with that dispel there. Interrupting the Chaos Bolts, gouge on the Thugonomics. It looks like they're trying to make swaps onto Smexin. They stuck up Envious. They're looking to pressure Smexin. Thugonomics getting his pet. They spell lock Swapsy there. Smexin dropping a bit low here, but it looks like Envious is going to be free to just cast out those heals.
All right, Earthshock, Thunderstorm. Waz gets Earth Grab Totem there very far across the map. Nice play away from Smex and removing Waz for some time, but he does ultimately reconnect, grappling, hooking back over to Thugonomics. Envious trying to maybe pre-fade any stuns. Waz is making it difficult. He keeps going back and forth, running at Envious and then running away to try and bait a fade, but Envious ultimately does trade out his trinket. For now Waz, though, caught into a stun. No Chaos Bolts, though. Another Chastise. Envious currently with Apotheosis activated, so his smite reduces the cooldown quite rapidly of his stun, so he's going to be looking to get those rolling as much as possible with smite. We see Swapsy now dipping below half. He ducks behind the pillar. Currently, right now, Method Black, they're in the run part of the hit-and-run strategy, trying to restabilize, but Chaz actually traded out his entire defensive arsenal during that period of time, and now, potentially, Waz could be exposed moving forward.
Indeed, that was the Rapture Archangel and the Pain Suppression coming out from Chaz, just with some passive damage coming out on Swapsy, but a ton of pressure. Like we said, Super Rejects are just finding their stride on this map, getting out so much damage. The fear onto Chaz right now, they're bursting down Swapsy and Waz. They still have their own self-defensives. Mortal Coil comes out onto Waz. The Chaos Bolt's going to come flying in onto Chaz. A big one there, and he trinkets out of it. But yeah, beautiful knock coming in from Smex in there out of that bubble. And Chaz needs to do a lot of work now to keep his team alive.
All right, Chaz ducks behind the corner, gripping Swapsy back to the pillar as they head to reposition on this side due to that thunderstorm from Smexen, almost claiming a kill there before we even moved into dampening. But this game is looking so solid right now. There's one opening to kill Envious with Plunder Armor, and they're going to go for it. This is the one opening. They have to kill him 100-0 in this stunlock. Will they have the damage to do it? Swapsy's just unleashing devastating amounts of damage. They need to trigger. They're trying to pause and wait for the Guardian Angel to fade before pushing him over the edge in these last final seconds. Ray of Hope denies the kill for now. Envious survives the swap that Method Black needed to win the game. Can they buy enough time for that opportunity again, Joe?
Indeed, maybe they can. Thugonomics actually uses Demonic Resolve offensively there to be able to peel the with his fears there. So that was a great read by Thugonomics, knowing he needed to save Envious from the brink of death. Chaz, Swapsy, and Waz gave it all they could, but now their kill opportunity is lost until that Plunder Armor comes back, and we're in dampening once again. Chaz is low on mana, and like you said, Sid, it could be hard for him to drink here.
All right, Smex is just raining down pain with that Stormkeeper chain lightning onto the whole team. I'd like to see Thugonomics reposition. Whoa. He's moving forward. Triangle position. Nice Thunderstorm. Smexen setting up for a target swap to Chaz maybe, but Waz stuns Thugonomics away at the end of that Thunderstorm. Smexen looking for a cheeky Hex onto Swapsy. Deny some pressure and also apply some to Chaz as well. And with dampening starting to ramp up, it will be difficult for Chaz to survive. Waz, Chaos Bolt straight to the face, but not enough damage to take him down. Chaz is the one that's still struggling though with his entire team so dangerously low. Any Chaos Bolt could claim the life of Waz. No Cloak of Shadows for 10 more seconds. Thugonomics not able to get a cast off right now as Waz knows Chaos Bolt is deadly. He's doing his best to deny it. Nice banish onto the Shadow Fiend. Potentially gets kicked. That was good protection from Waz. They need to protect the Shadow Fiend. That gives Chaz mana back when it attacks. So nice job by Waz.
Indeed, a great job by Waz, knowing that they need that mana that is coming down to that once again. And he needs a bit more time for that next Plunder Armor. A blind onto him as he trinkets out of it.
So Waz,
it could happen again. He had to use his human racial Cloak of Shadows there, overlapped with the Rapture by Chaz as well to survive those Chaos Bolts. They would have just probably died otherwise.
All right, Thugonomics has Unending Resolve and he has Soul Harvest. Stormkeeper has been channeled. Smexen is ready and waiting to unleash a huge Chain Lightning onto the entire team. Triple Chain Lightning. Chaz ducks behind the corner. Swapsy only really taking the brunt of that exchange. The positioning from Thugonomics and Smexen, not the best it could be. They need one player on one side and one person on the other, so at least one of them can cast, but right now they're kind of stacked up and Method Black are able to survive due to this mispositioning. Smexen moving in, potential Thunderstorm. He's moving in with Ghost Wolf, looking for it. Yes, Chaz gets knocked into the pillar, unfortunately. Smexen was trying to set up MVP play there. He lands a Hex with a Mortal Coil on Swapsy to deny the Dispel for a couple of seconds. There's the Chastise stun. He gets gripped right around the corner, though. Nice positioning from Chaz.
Indeed, Thugonomics was just trying his best to get these Chaos Bolts, but it looks very hard for him against Method Black. Chaz and Swapsy are doing an excellent job of being behind that pillar, just line of sight them, and Waz also interrupted him throughout the game. A Chaos Bolt looks like it might land onto Waz, a huge chunk of his HP, and every time he lands a Chaos Bolt, he might not necessarily get a kill, but Chaz has to deep further and further in his mana, and it looks like Super Rejects will take this if Waz doesn't pop that Plunder Armor soon and punish Envious for not having his trinket.
Well, yeah, the no trinket. They've been getting trinket with blind, and that's the opening that they can take for a kill. They've got enough mana to make a push, but they're going to have to commit defensive cooldowns to stay stable enough to stay in the middle of the map. Smex another Stormkeeper. He's ready to go. Chain Lightning's lined up, and they're flying. Swapsy down at half, Waz down at half. Chaz doing his best, drops a barrier, but only really himself inside of it. Swapsy ducks into the cover of the shield. Waz trying to as well. Smex moves into knock them out. Nice thunderstorms from Smexen in this game.
Indeed, Smex have been playing very good on the Elemental Shaman, just been harassing Chaz the entire game, trying to get off his Vim and Vigor. That's probably the reason why he's so low on mana. Another spell look as well, overlapped with the Windshield. Waz dropping low, he doesn't have his trinket either. He does have the Cloak of Shadows needed. They make a go on to Smexin. Chaos Bolt's coming out there. Waz using his hook back to line up slide. Those well played from Waz, and it's getting deeper and deeper into dampening.
Yeah, now they need to get Envious's trinket with blind again, and if Envious can be greedy and sit it, then there's no opening to kill him later. So I really want to see Smexin's economics peel so Envious can sit a full blind. In the meantime, Swapsy tossing out some chain lightnings, trying to finally develop some sort of momentum. Their team has had basically none this entire game, almost except one point in almost a 10-minute game. There's the double mortal coil, instant dispel, but into a chastise. He gets gripped back behind the corner. Will it be enough? Chaz's life grips have been MVP, really, this game to save his team in these moments. And Thuganomics Smexin, this positioning is not good. They're on top of each other. They need to reposition. Thuganomics trying to go to the other corner of the pillar now. They need to get that triangle going, or they can just easily line of sight both of them. Thuganomics now getting set up on a bunch of damage being lobbed forward by Swapsy. Nether Ward reflecting the lobbers back to Swapsy. Now he's down below half. Chaz gets windsheared. There's the Stormkeeper. Lots of chain lightnings. They need the good positioning. They need triangle positioning. Thuganomics is wrapping around to close in and pincer them off. I'm not sure how much longer Chaz can keep this up. Triple Infernal. Thuganomics has moved in. He's likely to be channeling Chaos Bolts. Pain Suppression, Astral Shift, Overlap. Chaz gets caught into a chastise. In this position, they have so much. Smexin is the only open target, and he needs to be careful of that. He's got no trinket. He could easily get 100-0 if he overextends, but at this point, Super Rejects are just stalling it out to victory.
Indeed, on to 30% dampening, ladies and gentlemen. Super Rejects are looking phenomenal right now. It looks like it's their game to lose at this point. Method Black, they need to find an opening, and they need to find it now. It looks like they're just going to be line of sight. Maybe look to out-dampen them with Ghost and be able to survive, but I don't know how they're going to do it. Swapsy and Waz are just very low on HP. Chaz has relatively no mana. I don't think he's ever going to be able to recover. Topping them off right now, a gouge onto Thuganomics, Spelllock onto Swapsy. They're just stopping their own pressure. Waz dropping low. The stun gets used on him. He's not using his trinket just yet, but the Chaos Bolt would land. That, oh, he just about trinket and uses that Cloak of Shadows, but now he probably won't have that for the rest of the game. The Stormkeeper comes out as well. Smexin trying to get a lot of pressure. He really wants to get that Vim and Vigor down. Chaz using the Light Swap. He's getting chugged down by Smexin. He's doing an excellent job of this Ellie Shaman. All three of them are so low right now, and then, oh, Waz getting stunned out again. He needs to be so careful going in the opening now.
Smexin is just 1v3ing, but he may have overextended for far too long. Ray of Hope allows Smexin to hang on. He's been trying his best to 1v3. Thuganomics' positioning has just been off. He needs to be on the other side of the pillar. He's right behind Smexin. He can't get any damage off. They blind Thuganomics to go for an all-in on Smexin through the defensive cooldowns. Will Envious be able to heal through this high of dampening still? And now a mind control on Envious. Chaz has nothing left. They stun him out. They swap to Smexin. Smexin has no astral shift. Are they actually going to kill Smexin? No, he jumps in. He doesn't care. It's all or nothing at this point, Joe.
Indeed, Method Black are running on fumes. They have absolutely no defensive apart from Swapsy of the astral shift. Chaos Bolt comes flying in. Waz dropping super low. They're just all line of sight in for their lives. They just want to try and survive and find a kill opportunity on the Smexin now. He has no astral shift. There's no ray of hope. They could potentially find it, but Swapsy and Waz and Chaz, they're just so in such a dire situation.
Look at the positioning. Thuganomics on one side, Smexin on the other. You're Method Black in the middle. It's a Method Black sandwich. Where are you going to go? They're just going to tear you apart and eat you up. Chaz has nothing left. Caught into the chastise stun. Smexin dipping low. Potential cross kill, but with cooldowns available, I don't think maybe it would be a bit of...
Everybody has Bricks crowd control. Everybody knows what it does. This, however, is the Blessing of Sanctuary, and what this spell does is it removes fear effects as well as stun effects. Now, the Rhett also has a built-in trinket in his artifact, which after 2 seconds takes him out of a crowd control. So you need to gouge the Rhett to proc his artifact, then you need to force his trinket by going on him, then you need to stun Kolo to force out the Blessing of Sanctuary, and then when you have all of those buttons, you fear up Envious, you swap to Kolo, who already used his trinket on the blind, and that is the only way you can survive that situation is if Envious uses his bubble to save Kolo with that Blessing of Protection. Now, if they just Blessing of Protection on the blind earlier, this situation wouldn't exist. Or if they saved their Hand of Sacrifice, they also wouldn't be in this situation. So what it comes down to is one mismanaged cooldown from Envious is going to lead to this situation where he has no bubble.
What can we see here?
I don't know, Rich. It's Runes of Lordaeron, and it is a cemetery. That would be a fitting final resting place for North America. I messed it up, man. Oh, all right. Oh, well. We see here as Smexin takes to the tomb. Waz is waiting to attack. He's going to cheap shot Smexen. He gets knocked away, though, by Smexen. Thugnox looking for castles. I like Chaz. His positioning on the side of the map over where the tombstones are. You can use those for quick line of sight to avoid fear and chaos bolts, and that's really good positioning on this map against a destruction warlock.
Indeed. Chaz and Swarms are going to be looking for that as well. The pit is all game to just line of sight Thugnox. They get a stun up Waz as well. Try and get some caster damage, and one chaos bolt comes flying out. Chaz just using the Archangel to keep them alive for now. A full blind on Envious instantly gets Trinket again, and Mepha Black needs to capitalize on those opportunities for the Plunderama.
The tricks of the trade used there. Swapsy trying to get some damage up, but getting counter-pressured by Smexen. Smexen looking to line up a Stormkeeper. Really good positioning from Method Black so far this game. Really was only the target for the Super Rejects. He gets Life Grip, though, back to the Tombstones on the side. Now he's able to capitalize on that positioning as well. This is a lot of damage potentially with the Apotheosis popped. Envious is looking to build up as many Chastise stuns as possible, so this is smart play from Method Black to duck around the corner, that hit-and-run style. Avoid the pressure, avoid the Apotheosis. As soon as it's over, then they're going to make another push.
Indeed, Chaz actually ended up using the Rapture there as well to kind of just keep them alive for now, dipping into his mana just a little bit, and they're going to start up Specs and trying to get some pressure on him. Envious is going to keep him alive. The Apotheosis is gone now. Full fear on the Chaz. It actually just breaks instantly. Specs and casting
swap. On
him. They make a swap onto Envious, and this is the Plunderama. This is the go to kill, and they want to do it right now. They might be able to do it. The Guardian Spirit proc, though, they could do it. The DR stun and maybe finish him off. They're unable to finish him. He just about gets the fade in time, and Envious, by the skin of his teeth, is alive.
I was waiting for you to just say finish really loudly, because that was so close. They almost managed to nail it there. If they had a Joe Fernandez execute, he would have fallen there. Envious hangs on by a thread. We can see Waz just ducking around now, looking for any opportunities. And I like that Chaz is drinking on the far part of this right-hand side of the map. That way it baits Thugonomics and Smexen to run into the center of the tombstones, which is exactly the positioning that Method Black want them to stand in, so they can easily hit and run almost at the same time. So this is really good positioning from Chaz on this map. They definitely had it planned out to begin with, and it's going to be up to Super Rejects to figure out how they want to deal with this. I'd like to see some more triangle positioning. Thugonomics could walk in a straight line basically to where Swapsy is, I feel, and that would be a better position. Envious could take the tomb. At the position they're in right now, Waz is able to attack Smexen and avoid Chaos Bolt. That's not what they want.
Indeed, Smexen is doing an extra drop, pushing in and making it difficult for Chaz to keep up that Vim and Vigor and keep up his healing. But like you say, Method Black are kind of just baiting Smexen in, knowing that Thugonomics and Envious is going to be far away. They want to allow Smexen to push and maybe overextend and find an opportunity to get cooldowns through hitting him. Swapsy getting swapped too. He doesn't have the trinket. They actually use the first Envious stun onto Swapsy now, but he gets life gripped immediately by Chaz, and it looks like they'll be okay for now.
All right, Smexen's still trying to get some work done, but this tombstone is a little bit tricky. Stormkeeper, lots of damage, potentially chain lightnings onto Chaz and Swapsy. They split up, each one taking a tombstone so they don't stack for cleave. Rain of Fire only going to be hitting one member as well. Swapsy getting knocked out, but jumps back instantly on that knock. We see Envious being greedy. He knows the blind is to try and set up a bait for a swap. Nice grappling hook sap from Waz, but he needs to get back to the target. Smexen, Astral Shift gets traded out. Will that be enough? No follow-up crowd control on Envious. No, a stun from Waz. Waz doing his best to keep Envious locked out of the game as they gun down Smexen. A nice Serenity heal from Envious, though, will start maybe not be enough. Envious spamming out heals, but Smexen is still just so low. Pressure from Swapsy insanely high. They do ultimately get Envious's trinket, so now he's open for a swap later on.
Indeed, Envious uses trinket to keep him up because Waz popped that Plunder Armor at low HP, so Envious had to trinket keep him alive right there, but he did save the Ray of Hope. But now his trinket's only lined up with the Plunder Armor. It's not going to be lined up with the blind, so there could be some potential for Method Black to take down Smexen before he gets his trinket back as well.
All right, Swapsy just covering behind. You see at the tombstone, the Thugonomics can't attack anyone in this positioning. I'd love to see him just push forward. He's the most tanky member on the team right now. He's the least vulnerable in the sense of defensive cooldowns, and it's really Smexen that's playing a risky game right now by being this far forward. At any moment, Waz could just gun for him. They go for a swap. They fear him out of the cheap shot. Perfect setup. He Cloak of Shadows the fear to immune the peels from Thugonomics. Will there be? He gouges up the Ray of Hope. Unfortunately, not enough. Maybe enough crowd control to deny the Ray of Hope. It ultimately does bring him back to full HP. Envious recovers. Really good play there, but Waz traded his cloak. They catch Chaz. Chaz tried to make an aggressive push. He's in the middle of the map. Thugonomics is lining up a Chaos Bolt. Gets denied, though, by Waz. Good denial, Chaz. Instantly going back to that defensive posture. Swapsy lining up a Stormkeeper now. Trying to get some counter pressure, but not finding too much. It's difficult to kind of punch through the Holy Priest healing without a stun lock.
Indeed. Smexen doing an extra job. He knocked them in the open, and that's what's caused this chaos from Method Black, having to use that Pain Suppression and the Astral Shift. And Chaz has defended it. Difficult to struggle topping them off, really, and dampening its just about kicked in, so the game's pretty much just started for Super Rejects. Maybe Thuganomics, like I said, could push in with Smexin, get some more casted pressure, but it looks like they're trying to keep their distance in between each other, so it makes it difficult for Waz to get these setups.
Yep. Waz is trying to separate from his team so they don't stack up for triple cleave from Rain of Fire or Chain Lightnings, and at this point it's free reign for Super Rejects as Method Black are on the back foot with no Cloak of Shadows. They need to stall out for that. It's too risky to go into the center field without it. He could easily go down. Chaz has no defensive cooldowns. If he overextends, he could get erased from the arena. Thugonomics finally repositioning to more of a triangle position, and with this positioning they can finally get some damage out at least. Now Smexin might be able to move forward. He's got Trinket and Astral Shift. He should be feeling fairly safe. Envious has Trinket as well. Waz likely go for blind. He's baiting a trinket. He needs to get a trinket, not even just bait it. Envious is trying to be greedy because he knows that Waz needs to get it. Will he get the sap out of the blind? He gets the sap. Smexin now gets swapped to. He's got Astral Shift. He has to trade it out. He might have traded it out too late. Will they have enough damage to crush through it? Dampening is just starting to mount. Smexin's feeling the pain. Envious does trinket human racials out of that. He will have another trinket though to break out, I believe, later on. He used his undead racial to break out of the psychic cream, so he can trinket a stun later on. Nice read from Envious. Now he's not an open target. And now that they've remove that threat, I'd really like to see the Super Rejects get aggressive.
Indeed, they actually make a swap over to Thuganomics, but he's been holding on to that Demonic Resolve the entire game and even been using it defensively for those fears, so it's going to be interesting to see if they're able to maybe change their win condition onto Thuganomics, but I really think they can only really kill Envious or Smex, and the DR Hex comes out from Swoxy trying to peel some of that pressure. Infernal Stun's coming in from Thuganomics. It looks like they're both just on top of the tomb trying to just dogpile on that, get rid of Chaz's Vim and Vigor, and again just look to out-tempered them. Oh, the swap onto Envious, and this is the Plunder Armor. He trinkets it now. Trinket fades, so he's going to immune that damage, uses that Serenity to just top himself up completely. And, well, now Waz could use the blind onto Envious if they want to set up a kill onto Smexin.
Yeah, later on, when blind comes off cooldown, Smexin will likely be the kill target, will be the fall for the Super Rejects if they're not careful. They've got a couple of time, a bit of time before that point, and they need to play aggressive with it. I really feel like the Super Rejects are playing too passively. This is an obvious downtime for Method Black where they can't get a lot of pressure out, and they're really not capitalizing on the downtime at all. And I think Thuganomics is the one that could be really starting to mount momentum. He's been very passive. He's just bouncing on the side of the tomb here, not really able to attack anyone, just dropping Rain of Fire and kind of just poking, but the positioning is not great. Smexin's doing his best to be the front runner, but he's getting mind controlled out of line of sight. Needs to be careful. Swaps against Life Crypt on the Chastise stun. There, Smexin gets stunned. Nice Thunderstorm, though, removing Waz away. He's got Curse of the Dreadblades, though. Envious needs to be careful. This is potentially a lot of damage. There's the blind with no trinket. This is the setup to win. And Smexin's in the middle of the map with nothing left to really keep him going. Clinical precision there from Method Black. They knew exactly what they wanted to do, and Europe continues its domination.
Sure does, and ultimately, Method Black is one of the teams that we knew it could. They could be from Mars. They would be a scary team. It really doesn't matter what region they are from. They have been one of the most dominant squads this year. And now we're seeing Waz. You know, we haven't got to see him really get excited up on the stage. Only the second land of the year, but we're starting to see Waz getting a little bit hyped up there. And Method Black, I mean, they're such a scary team because we don't even know what their main comp is right now, Zico. They are just so impressive in so many different play styles.
Yeah, they just have so many different ways to play the game, and they can play them all on a high level. These guys play cleaves, they can play wizard cleaves, they can play, you know, dampening comps that kill fast, new comps that we haven't really seen, like the Ellie Outlaw. These guys are innovators, and they are perfecting multiple classes at the same time, and that is why so many teams are just simply put scared of going up against this titan of a roster, because they have...
I'm joined here with the very excited Waz after a very impressive performance against the Super Rejects. How are you feeling after your first series?
We've been feeling so weird up coming to this tournament. Like, their comps are super hard, and don't know, I think we adapted really well after the first game that we lost against them. So yeah, we're feeling great. They were definitely one of the scarier teams, together with the move, because we haven't faced them, we don't really know how they play, and yeah, we got to war game them a bit, so I think that helped us out a lot.
Seems like that's the main concern of Europe, just sort of getting a feel for what compositions that they're really bringing. At the Spring Finals, you guys didn't have your full roster with Raikou. How much more confident are you guys here now that you guys are at full strength?
I definitely think the last land we went to, that if Raikou was there, we definitely have won, but I don't know, I think I was more comfortable and confident back then, but I don't know, there's good teams here this tournament, so it's going to be hard regardless of Raikou being here.
Yeah, it's an insanely difficult tournament, but you guys are definitely up for the task. Are you guys happy with anything but a first place finish, or are you guys going for it all?
Yeah, of course we're happy with anything. Top three is the goal, as always. We're almost qualified to BlizzCon anyway, so placing top three would be amazing.
Well, hopefully you guys can pull it off. Thanks for the interview. Back to you, Rich.